Resolve's new surface tracker is crazy powerful and surprisingly simple to use.
So first of all, in Resolve's color page, we're gonna open up the effects library in the top right corner, and then we search for surface tracker. Then the new surface tracker will come up, and then you have two options to apply the surface tracker onto your node tree. You can either click and drag and drop this onto the node that's already there, or drag and drop this onto this line right here to automatically create the surface tracker node for you. And in the surface tracker in the effects library, you can see that we have a bounce, mesh, track, and result window. And we're gonna start things out in the bounce window. In the bounce window, we determine the area that we want to track, and for us, this is this line right here. So, with the surface tracker node selected, make sure you're in the bounce window, and then you can come over to your preview window and just create a rough shape of the area that you want to track. If, however, this doesn't work for you, make sure you have the open effects overlay toggled on. If this is off, you can click and nothing will happen. So let's just open the open effects overlay, and then if we click, you can see that we can create like any shape that we want. And right now what we want to do is we want to create just a rough rectangle on this lion's side right here. Something like that will do the job just fine. But you will quickly notice that we have no mesh, and in order to create the mesh, you have to go to the mesh window. Just click that. Once it's loaded, you can see all those little dots and the mesh has been created for you. Now you can either refine the mesh by clicking on each of those points and rearranging them, or you can create new points by clicking in between those lines to create new points. Then you have the options for point locations, automatic or uniform grid. If you change it to uniform grid, as the name suggests, it will make it a uniform grid, but we're gonna stick to automatic, and we don't have to take care about all the points because I've tested it previously and DaVinci Resolve almost always does a pretty good job with the automatic point locations. So we might want to add a simple point right here and there to make sure that everything is covered. And right now we can come over to the tracker window and hit this button if you're somewhere in the middle, because this will just set the frame that you're currently on as a reference frame, and then track forward from this frame to the end, and then jump back to the reference frame and then track everything back. Let's just track forward and then reverse. And what that's doing is DaVinci Resolve will track each of those points to its location on the lion or any surface that you try to track something to. So right now the tracking is completed, and if we come down to our keyframe section at the bottom right of your screen, you can see that we've created a couple of keyframes. And what we're gonna do right now, this might seem a little bit boring, but we're just gonna place a DaVinci Resolve logo on that lion. So let's go up to our media pool where we have our DaVinci Resolve PNG file, and let's just drag and drop this over to our node editor, and we can close the media pool just for now. So what we wanna do right now with this external mat is take the green output and connect it into the green input of our surface tracker, and then take the blue or the alpha output from the external mat and connect it into the alpha input of the surface tracker. And right now you can see that this looks just a little bit horrible, and we can fix that in just a second. So first of all, let's go to our surface tracker, then go over to effects. And now jump into the result tab, and under overlay placement, make sure that you select this drop down, select go to reference. And this will bring us back to our reference frame where we started the tracking forward and then backwards. And if we zoom out just a little bit, you can see that we have this grid. We can select each of those corners, and what we're gonna do with this is just make sure that we place it inside of the box that we've tracked. Something like this. And if, as you can see right now, the DaVinci Resolve logo is starting to appear inside of that box. Something like that should do the job just fine. So once you've placed your image inside of that tracking area, we can then jump back to the edit page and basically just rewatch what we've just created in a matter of seconds. And as you can see, the DaVinci Resolve logo is like perfectly tracked to the lion's back. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. If so, please consider leaving a like and a comment. That would mean a ton to me. But anyways, hope you're having a great day. See you in the next one. Bye.